My name is Charles Little Coyote. My Indian name is Mianan, Morning Killer. This, what I'm saying now, is what was told me. I did not read it in the book.
What I heard about Sand Creek goes through my father. My father's mother was about 5 to 6 years old enough to remember what took place. At the beginning of early that morning, they always said that it was in the morning where there was light enough to see. And that they seen these soldiers coming from the south.
Most of the men, the warriors as you call them, were gone. They were probably out on a hunt or something.
Black cattle had been told that as long as they had this American flag with the white flag, it would indicate that they were peaceful and that nobody would bother them.
My grandfather told how they were awakened, and his mother awakened him when the troops came into the camp.
These soldiers opened fire on them, shot at them.
Black Kettle said, told the people not to be afraid, that they wouldn't harm them. He was putting up the flag, the United States flag, and put the little white flag underneath. And he told them to gather around, and they all surrounded him.
It was like a shooting gallery.
My great-granddad always told me that, he said, my young mommy won. He io kashkunia, he tanya te elderly. He always told me that they were all crying, moaning. Some of them were not quite dead. After they got shot, they were suffering. And the kids. This one story he was telling me, that I was this soldier, he seen the kid running in the sand along the bank. He was just a small, he wasn't hardly big enough to carry anything. And he was crying and looking for his mother. And the soldier was shooting at him. He missed him. Here come another one. He rode up and told him, he said, let me try it. So he missed him too. So finally, this other guy said, let me do it. He shot that little baby. I don't think he was even out of his diapers, the way great-granddad told me.
When they got through shooting at him, my father said he was told that the time when they quit shooting at him was an issue, said the voice. And that meant it was already, the sun was already straight up. When Comet Siva, my great-grandfather, came back after everything was over, I don't know how long afterward he came back, but he came back to look for his younger sister. said to a teller woman. And his two kids. Come and see what's it. When I went back to my lodge, all that he found was ashes. I guess they burned his lodge down. He found his pipe. And he said, women, babies, the elderly people, and children. He said they all laid dead there at Sand Creek.
They took some of the parts of the women and the children and sold them for souvenirs in Denver and other places.
Some of the atrocities is difficult for women, Cheyenne women, to even talk about. To give details, it's not really for some of us to say.
Well, after the battle at Sand Creek, they didn't have too much respect for the soldiers. They were always on the lookout for the soldiers.
They never trusted the white people anymore. They joined the renegades. They condoned what they did after that.
What happened to the Cheyenne at that time, I guess you would say it was the utmost or the most tragic thing that happened to a group of Cheyennes at one time. I would say today that the majority of people that, or all the people that has Cheyenne blood in them, would probably feel the same way. That day we'll always remember it.
Charles Little Coyote. My Indian name is Mianan, Morning Killer. This, what I'm saying now, is what was told me. I did not read it in the book.
What I heard about Sand Creek goes through my father. My father's mother was about 5 to 6 years old, old enough to remember what took place. At the beginning of early that morning, they always said that it was in the morning where there was light enough to see. And that they seen these soldiers coming from the south.
Most of the men, the warriors as you call them, were gone. They were probably out on a hunt or something.
Black Kettle had been told that as long as they had this American flag with the white flag, it would indicate that they were peaceful and that nobody would bother them.
My grandfather told how they were awakened, and his mother awakened him when the troops came into the camp.
These soldiers opened fire on them, shot at them.
Black Kettle said, told the people not to be afraid, that they wouldn't harm them. He was putting up the flag, the United States flag, and put the little white flag underneath. And he told them to gather around, and they all surrounded him.
It was like a shooting gallery.
My great-granddad always told me that, he said, my young mommy won. He ill, got shikunia, he done ill to elderly. He always told me that they were all crying, moaning. Some of them were not quite dead. After they got shot, they were suffering. And the kids. This one story he was telling me, that I was this soldier, he seen the kid running in the sand along the bank. He was just a small, he wasn't hardly big enough to carry anything. And he was crying and looking for his mother. And the soldier was shooting at him. He missed him, here come another one. He rode up and told him, he said, let me try it. So he missed him too. So finally, this other guy said, let me do it. He shot that little baby. I don't think he was even out of his diapers, the way great-granddad told me.
When they got through shooting at him, my father said he was told that the time when they quit shooting at him was an issue, said the voice. And that meant it was already, the sun was already straight up. Up above. When Comet Siva, my great grandfather, came back after everything was over, I don't know how long afterward he came back, but he came back to look for his younger sister, Shinoa Pa'ea. tell a woman. And his two kids. Come and see was that when I went back to my lodge, all that he found was ashes. I guess they burned his lodge down. He found his pipe. And he said, women, babies, the elderly people, and children. He said they all laid dead there at Sand Creek.
They took some of the parts of the women and the children and sold them for souvenirs in Denver and other places.
Some of the atrocities is difficult for women, Cheyenne women, to even talk about. To give details, it's not really for some of us to say.
Well, after the battle at Sand Creek, they didn't have too much respect for the soldiers. They were always on the lookout for the soldiers.
They never trusted the white people anymore. They joined the renegades. They condoned what they did after that.
What happened to the Cheyenne at that time, I guess you would say it was the utmost or the most tragic thing that happened to a group of Cheyennes at one time. I would say today that the majority of people that, or all the people that has Cheyenne blood in them, would probably feel the same way. That they will always remember it.